ever since the constitutional referendum of 1964, which was carried out on the 31st of January 1964, when the Ghanaian people overwhelmingly voted for Dr. Kwame Nkrumah to be the life president of Ghana, the issue of life presidency has been setting Africa back, and it is time to solve it. I am Eze Chimere Nwauzo. I'm an author, author of The Wisdom and the Power of African Unity, author of 202 Questions and Answers About African Progress. I'm the leader of One Africa Family OAF, and our vision is to lead Africans from last to first. The people of Ghana had good intentions for voting Dr. Kwame Nkrumah to be the life president of Ghana. And Dr. Kwame Nkrumah had good intentions for becoming the life president of Ghana because he was the best African leader of his time, and he had many dreams to carry out in his lifetime. He wanted to industrialize Ghana in a lifetime, and he wanted to industrialize Africa and to have the United States of Africa. Because of all these reasons, the Ghanaian people voted him to be the life president of Ghana. But the intentions that the people of Ghana had is not the intention that the people that now want to stay in office for life have. The African leaders that want to stay forever in office now want to stay in office to serve their own interest and to serve the interest of the colonizers of Africa. Therefore, this has become a monster in Africa that has to be laid to rest. Now let's talk about presidential term limits, its origin, and its rationale. Presidential term limits is a rule that states that the president of a country should rule for only 2 terms of about 4 to 5 years each. That means a president should rule for at most 8 to 10 years. The origin of this presidential term limit can be traced to President George Washington, the first president of the United States of America, who ruled America from the year 1789 to the year 1797. He refused to rule forever. He retired and went back home. Subsequent presidents of the US followed the pattern of President George Washington and ruled for only 2 terms of 8 years at most and resigned. However, the second president of the US, President Eleanor Roosevelt, ruled for 4 tenures, lasting from the year 1933 to the year 1945. He died in office 2 months into his 4th tenure. President Franklin Delano Roosevelt is known to have ruled America in the midst of the Great Depression. The Great Depression is the worst economic crisis in American history. As of the time of President Delano's inception into office, about 2 million Americans were homeless, about 13 million jobs were lost, and half of production was going on from what they had by year 1929. 32 out of 48 states then in America had closed their banks. President Roosevelt was able to lift America's hopes high and was able to lift America from that economic depression. Also, President Franklin Roosevelt was able to lead America during the Second World War, which occurred from the year 1939 to the year 1945. He was also instrumental to the founding of the United Nations, together with Winston Churchill of UK, Stalin of USSR, and Chiang Kai-shek, the leader of China. With all this, historians rank him as among the greatest presidents of the United States of America after presidents George Washington and President Abraham Lincoln. But even at that, the US Congress in the year 1951 passed the 22nd Amendment to the US Constitution that made it illegal for any president of America to go beyond second tenure. These are the reasons why there are presidential term limits. Number one, giving a person presidency gives person a lot of power. Presidents control so much power that they are like monarchs. And one of the ways to checkmate the power of a president is by allowing the president to rule for a certain period of time and not more. Also, there are other fresh leaders who have fresh ideas that they can bring into office. But when a person has ruled for about 8 years or about 10 years, the person has lost any incentive or any new idea to bring into the table. Thirdly, we are supposed to have presidential term limits because no one has a right to rule and does not have a right to be ruled. You rule and others should rule. No one person is made to rule over others forever. It is only a contract that others give you or a period of time they give you to rule them. And after that, you are also supposed to step down for another person to rule. Fourthly, there is need for there to be presidential limits so that other ideologies that other people are going to represent will be represented. For example, President George Bush represented the ideology of those who wanted Americans to go to war. President Obama represented the interest of African Americans as the first African American president, even though he didn't do so much for African Americans. Then you have President Donald Trump representing the evangelical Christians. So the more you have term limits and new presidents, you represent other ideologies that one person cannot represent fully. Because of that, presidents in America after second tenure, they step down. Presidents in other parts of the world, they step down after staying for two terms in office. However, African leaders have not been following the same pattern. Instead, African leaders want to rule forever. For example, President Eyadema Nsingbe began to rule Togo from the year 1967, and he ruled Togo to the year 2005, and he died in office. As of the time of his presidency, he was the longest serving president in Africa, and he served for 38 years. And after his death, he passed over the baton of leadership to his son, Fore Nasingbe, who is still the president of Togo, even as I speak. President Teodoro Obiang became the president of Equatorial Guinea in the year 1979 after executing his uncle, Francisco Nguema, and executing him through firing squad. He has been the president of Equatorial Guinea since then, even till now. From the year 1989 to the year 2019, President Omar Al Bashir ruled Sudan. From the year 1969 to the year 2011, President Muammar Gaddafi ruled Libya. Although his own tenure, we know that he did a lot of good things. President Mugabe ruled Zimbabwe from the year 1980 to the year 2017, 37 years. President Idris Dabi began to rule Chad since the year 1990. Most of these presidents want to rule forever. And there are about 10 African heads of states that have ruled for over 30 years. They are all in this category. And if you ask what they have achieved, you can hardly find what something tangible that you can say that they have achieved or they achieved in office. Because in the year 2011, President Jammeh, the president, then president of Gambia, told the BBC that African leaders should not be judged by how long they stayed in office, but by what they do in office. Now let's check what these leaders did in office. Compare them to President Lee Kuan Yew, who was president or prime minister of Singapore from the year 1959 to the year 1990. He was able to transform Singapore from a third world nation to a first world nation single-handedly. Now, is Togo a first world nation now? Is Sudan a first world nation? Uganda, is he a first world nation? President Museveni has been ruling Uganda since the year 1986 after a five-year guerrilla war when he became the president of Uganda. Has Uganda become a first world nation? Which African nation has become a first world nation by having African leaders who rule 30 years? What you still find out is that these leaders rule for themselves and they still maintain the interests of the colonizers who put them in office. And this is what we have been having. Therefore, we cannot allow this to continue. But on a better note, let us remember that the presidential term limit is not the only problem we have in this category. There was also the problem of coups and illegitimate takeover of power in Africa, starting from the first presidential coup, which occurred on 13th of January 1963 in Togo, when Emmanuel Bojolo and Fore Nasingbe assassinated Ovio, the first president of Togo. And some years later, Eyadema became the president of Togo in 1967. Since then, there have been a series of coups in Africa, of over 60 of them. Yeah, even before then, in 1952, there was the Egyptian Revolution, when Gamal Abdel Nasser took over from President Farouk, or from King Farouk. That should be called a revolution more than a coup, because that was overthrow of monarchy. But the first presidential coup in Africa was 13th of January 1963. And since then, there have been presidential coups going on across Africa. Until in the year 2000, the OAU passed the Lomé Declaration that made it illegitimate for there to be illegitimate transfer of power and to institute sanctions whenever such occurs. Also, in the treaty establishing the Peace and Security Council, which was signed on the 9th of July 2002, the African Union also mandated the Peace and Security Council to institute sanctions whenever necessary or whenever there was an illegitimate takeover of power, as was made available in the 2000 Lomé Declaration. There are also other series of charters and declarations made by the African Union to make sure that any country that carries out such will be punished. Therefore, in Guinea 2008, Madagascar 2009, Niger 2010, Central African Republic 2013, and in Mali 2012 and 2020, the African Union immediately suspended these countries from the organization and instituted sanctions on the coup plotters. Because of this, there has been so much reduction in the amount of coups in Africa, because they know that the African Union is not going to tolerate that. Therefore, the solution to the issue of term limits or life presidency in Africa is to follow the same pattern. The African Union should institute a statute that states that African leaders should not stay in office beyond 2 terms or beyond 3 terms, depending on what the African Union wants to make it. And once that is done, the charter is signed, that will be the end of it. The ECOWAS leaders tried to do so the same thing in the year 2015 at the ECOWAS summit that held in Ghana 2015. But Togo and Gambia refused to allow that statute to hold, because Togo, as we know it, Fore Nasingbe and then president of Gambia, Yahya Jammeh, are two leaders that want to stay in office forever. So because of that, they refused to allow that statute to be passed. African leaders must understand that there is life after presidency, and that the best a leader can do is not to stay in office forever, but to institute principles and to institute legacies that will last forever. That is the best way to stay in power forever. Now, the African Union must take the bull by the horn and place a presidential term limit on African leaders, so that this issue of lifetime presidency will be solved once and for all. God bless Africa. God bless the leaders and people of Africa. Jamaa.